On May 2, 2009, close to 2 million people on pay-per-view from around the world witnessed what would be later dubbed as the knockout of the year. It happened during a championship boxing match between the Philippines' Manny Pacquiao and the UK's Ricky Hatton. With 8 seconds left in the second round, Pacquiao caught Hatton with a vicious left hook to the chin. The British boxer promptly fell to the canvas, seemingly lifeless. Fortunately for Hatton, he was simply knocked unconscious for a few seconds. While that boxing episode proved how devastating Pacquiao's punch were during his prime, one other question needs to be answered. Why do people pass out when they get hit in the chin? The answer is called nervous system overload. Our brain is a mushy mass of nerves and blood vessels and is literally floating in a clear and colorless liquid known as the cerebrospinal fluid. This prevents the brain from getting in contact with the inside of our skull. But what happens when you fall down and hit your head, or in Hatton's case, got punched really hard? Imagine a drinking glass with water and an ice cube floating in it. When you give a good hard tap on the side of the glass, the ice cube is pushed toward the source of the blow. It slams on that side of the glass, rebounds, and then hits the opposite side. Depending on the hardness of the blow, the ice cube can hit the sides of the glass several times before it settles in the center once again. Now, imagine that drinking glass as your head and the ice cube your brain. The tap to the side is Pacquiao's power punch. When the chin is hit hard like that, it causes the head to spin at a high speed. But bones, muscles, and tendons immediately work together to stop the head from spinning further. Unfortunately, that causes the brain to crash into the inside of the skull, rebound, and hit the opposite side several times, just like the ice cube in the drinking glass. Crashing into the inside of the skull causes brain cells to die. This trauma causes the simultaneous firing of several neurotransmitters, an event the experts call a nervous system overload. And just like an overloaded computer, the brain suffers a system crash, leading to temporary paralysis. The result is loss of consciousness, with the muscles immediately relaxing. So that's why, after being hit with a Pacquiao haymaker to the chin, Hatton simply fell to the canvas like a sack of potatoes. Fortunately, that system overload is our body's way of coping with such a trauma. The person who got hit will not remember being hit and can just wake up with a headache. Of course, in severe cases, it can lead to death due to cerebral bleeding. We hope you like this episode of So That's Why. For more informative and fun videos, please don't forget to subscribe. Until next time.